Hi, I'm KB. This video is the main part of four videos I've made about and in different aspect ratios. These videos will hopefully make you understand how the different aspect ratios work and help you choose the best aspect ratio for your video work. I've put links to the four videos in the description and on the end screen. Oh, and this video is shot and presented in the 16:9 aspect ratio. So what is an aspect ratio? It is simply a number that describes how wide an image is compared to its height. This video being in the 16:9 ratio means that it is 16 units wide by 9 units high. The ratio can be represented in different ways. Commonly we say 16:9 or just 16:9. It is a way to describe a fraction with the numerator 16 and the denominator 9. This is also why the units don't matter. We can measure the image in meters, feet, inches, bananas, pixels, or whatever. Since the unit figures at both the top and the bottom of the fraction, it cancels out. This video is shot in 4K, that is 3840 pixels horizontally and 2160 pixels vertically. So the aspect ratio is 3840 pixels divided by 2160 pixels, the unit cancels out, and we can reduce the numerator and denominator by 240. 3840 divided by 240 is 16, and 2160 divided by 240 is 9. So we are left with the fraction 16:9. The aspect ratio is commonly written as 16:9, or sometimes as a decimal number, which is 1.7778. Especially in the cinema area, it is common to write it as a fraction with the denominator reduced to 1, as in 1.7778:1. But as you can see, it is really just the same value, just represented in different ways. So what are the different common aspect ratios? I'll concentrate on ratios commonly used on consumer devices. There are more ratios used in cinemas. It all started back in the 1930s with the first television sets. At the time, most movies were shot on 35mm film in the 4:3 aspect ratio, so the television industry chose that ratio for their screens. Televisions and most monitors and devices have since moved to wider formats, but it is still used on some devices. For instance, the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2021, which has a 4:3 screen. If you happen to watch this video on a 4:3 television monitor or device, you will see big black bars above and below the image. 25% of the total screen area will be wasted by black space. Some devices, notably some of the last 4:3 television sets, will allow you to zoom in on the image to fill the entire screen. But that will cut away 36% of the actual image from the sides. The 4:3 ratio got the name full screen. The movie industry began to lose cinema customers and started to utilize wider formats to differentiate themselves from television. The widescreen war had begun. Television viewers were unhappy by the black wasted areas on their screens, and movie fans were unhappy if the original film was cut or reframed to fill the TV screen. In a response to this, the television and broadcast industry began to move to a wider screen standard back in the 1990s. That new format was named widescreen, and the industry had to settle on an aspect ratio for the format. Broadcast companies had a lot of existing equipment to handle and broadcast the video signal. At the time, most of this was not done digitally, and due to the way physics works, squaring the ratio made it easier to handle the analog and optical scaling between legacy 4:3 broadcasts and the new format. If we square 4 divided by 3, you might remember from math class that to square a fraction, you square both the numerator and the denominator. So 4 squared is 16 and 3 squared is 9, and we get the new format 16:9. This ratio of 1.7778 is also closer to the golden ratio 1.6180 than the old 1.3333 ratio was. The golden ratio is supposedly the most pleasing to look at for the eye. By the end of the first decade of the 2000s, the new widescreen format has almost entirely replaced the old full screen for television sets and computer monitors, and it is today still by far the most used format for non-handheld devices. Since this video is shot in the 16:9, if you watch it on a 16:9 device, the image will fit the screen perfectly with no black areas. The movie and film industry has continued to push for wider formats to battle the declining cinemas and attendance. And the consumer electronic industry is moving as well. By the logic of raising the OG full screen ratio to increasing powers, the next logical step was cubing the ratio. 4 divided by 3 cubed is 4 cubed over 3 cubed. 4 cubed is 64 and 3 cubed is 27. So the chosen ratio was 64 by 27. The marketing departments couldn't handle that. And if you reduce a fraction by 3, you will get 21 1/3 by 9, which made it easier to compare with 16:9. Of course, 21 1/3 is not a number you can write on a marketing PowerPoint, so the ratio ended up being named 21:9, even though it is technically 64:27. The format was named ultrawide, but this term isn't as strict as its predecessors, and technically, any aspect ratio wider than 2:1 is considered ultrawide. In 2009, Philips launched a 21:9 television set, but the format really never took off in the broadcast and television world. But ultrawide monitors have found a place as displays for computers alongside the more common 16:9 monitors. And the majority of modern smartphones have an ultrawide display, at least if you turn them sideways. Otherwise, I'd guess that it would be considered ultra-narrow. If you watch this 16:9 video on a 64:27 ultrawide display, you will get black pillars on the side. 25% of the screen will be black wasted space. Just as much black as when watching 16:9 content on a 4:3 display. Some mobile phone apps, like YouTube, have a function to zoom the image to fill the display. But that will of course cut away the top and bottom part of the image to make it fit. So if you're making 16:9 content, which will be viewed on mobile devices, consider not putting essential elements at the top and the bottom. As a compromise between widescreen and ultrawide, a 2:1 aspect ratio is rising in popularity. This format is fully supported by YouTube. You can find a link to my video in 2:1 format in the description. So which aspect ratio should you choose for your video projects? Well, it depends. There is no universally best aspect ratio. The least common ratio nowadays is 4:3, but if you want to convey a retro feeling, or if you're targeting a specific 4:3 device like the iPad Pro, 4:3 is a perfectly valid option. On the other end of the scale is the ultrawide ratio. It is excellent if you want that cinematic feeling, or if your video will mostly be consumed on smartphones. If your audience is mainly on television sets or desktop computers, or if your source material is 16:9, like if you're streaming video games, it makes good sense to choose a 16:9 aspect ratio. And if your target audience is both on mobile phones and computer monitors, a good choice will be the 2:1 ratio. This will only give a small black areas on both types of devices. That is the reason that I mainly make my videos in the 2:1 format. The bottom line is, know your target audience's devices, know your source material, and consider if you want to convey a certain look or feeling, and choose a format based on those criteria. Down here in the corner, I've put links to my 4 videos in different aspect ratios. Go ahead and explore them and watch them on different devices to see how they work. And up here is a random video that YouTube thinks you might find interesting. Until next time, be happy and have fun.